Hey, my name is Jamie, and when I was in high school, I got stuck in an elevator with my crush. No, this wasn't just any crush. I've liked Ethan for like 2 years, but never really talked to him. The only class I've had with him was science, but even though I tried to get him as my lab partner, he already picked his friend on the basketball team. I would always daydream about situations where he would become my boyfriend on a walk home from school. One day, when I was a sophomore, we had the volleyball unit in gym class. Me and my girlfriends were playing against Becky. She always made fun of me and always tried to flirt with Ethan because she knew I secretly liked him. While we were playing, she started taunting me on the other side of the net because she knew I was good at volleyball. I told my friend to set me up so I could spike the ball at her. Right when the serve went over the net, my friend set it up close to the net. I jumped up and spiked it her way as hard as I could. The ball hit her right in the face, but bounced right back towards my feet. I landed right on the ball and my ankle made a loud snapping noise. Turns out, I broke my ankle in 3 different places, which meant a cast and crutches for at least a month. This sucked because not only was I out of the whole season of volleyball, but I couldn't rush to science class to get to the closest table to Ethan. When I arrived at school the next day with the crutches and cast, I was so embarrassed and scared people would be laughing at me, but no one really did. Plus, I got an elevator pass and a late pass so I could be 5 minutes late to any class. The class I was most nervous to go to was science class. I didn't want Ethan to see me in a cast because it was all ugly and big. I hurried to science so he wouldn't see me coming through the door late. After science class, the teacher asked the class who would like to help me to my next class with my backpack. To my surprise, Ethan raised his hand. My heart literally skipped a beat. I got so nervous and started to think of all the reasons why he raised his hand. Everyone started making their way out of the classroom, and Ethan came up to me, said hello, and picked up my backpack. As we were walking to the elevators, I got up the nerve to ask him why he wanted to escort me to my next class. He said it would let him be late for his English class, and he hated English. As we got in the elevator, we heard this beeping sound, but we thought it was normal, so we pressed floor 1 and the elevator started going. Then, as we were getting closer to ground level, the elevator jumped up and stopped to a screeching halt. We tried pressing all the buttons, pressing the alarm, everything, and the elevator didn't budge. We were yelling for help, but no one could hear us because we were in the elevator. I started to panic, but Ethan calmed me down. He convinced me that someone is probably already on their way to fix it. I then realized that this was the perfect time to get to know him. After we get out of this elevator, it'll all go back to how it used to be, him ignoring me. So, we started talking. We talked about basketball, science class, our fave teachers, how I broke my ankle. We talked half an hour, non-stop. When I brought up how the ball bounced off Becky's face, he laughed and told me that girl is so annoying. What I heard next, I couldn't believe. He told me that Becky told him I had a boyfriend that was in college and that I'm off limits and that's why he never talked to me. I told him she lied about all of that and I've always thought he was cute. That's when the speaker interrupted us. It was the principal. He said the crew was about to pry open the doors and get us out. The next couple days, he started saying hi to me everywhere he saw me. And this changed everything. I'm glad I hit Becky in the face with the volleyball. Let's just say, a year later, we went to prom together as boyfriend and girlfriend. Just wanted to tell my tale. Thanks for listening.